the first match between El Salvador and Trinidad and Tobago. Trinidadian side in a tremendous play as it was Jabari Mitchell making it 1-0.
Okay, so we're here with National Under-20 Men's head coach Brian Williams. Brian has just returned from San Jose, Costa Rica, where he led Trinidad and Tobago to a formidable performance at the tournament, unable to get through to the next phase, but ending the tournament on a high note with a victory against El Salvador. Coach, give us an idea of how things went across there.
Shawnee, I must say things went pretty comfortable, pretty decent. What is important is the exposure for our young players. The pre-tournament camp in Colombia, I think, was a big plus. Obviously, that we know that with, I wouldn't say taking away added support and stuff like that. I think for the future, I think our team will definitely do much better in those tournaments. I think those tournaments really call for a really higher level. Our boys did well, seeing the likes of our competitors who are already established in some of the big clubs in the respective countries. For example, in Costa Rica and the Honduras team, all those teams had the players coming out, young players coming out of Europe. And I think this is one of the areas, as I said before, I think we have to improve on really in trying to ensure that we have our best possible players to represent the country at these type of level tournaments, because I know in a CONCACAF finals going into under 20 World Cup, it really calls a high level tournament. Under 20 football is one of the football that even self most clubs and thing and agents looking at those type of young talented players. So I think it's important for us to improve in that aspect. Other than that, I think it was a good tournament for our youngsters. I was pretty satisfied with the improvement in play, the whole discipline and all that they carried during the tour, and I really want to compliment them.
Find Lanciquat looking to drive that ball through. Here's San Hilaire with a chance. It's a shot and it goes right through Trinidad. We're talking about passes the break lines. Well, there you go. Right there. That's what you needed. Lanciquat threading that ball through. Nothing that Carrillo could do on that.
Do you think that that extra 2 points from the first game against Bermuda would have cost us the chance to advance?
Definitely. I think that is the game you was looking at. You know, all due respect to Bermuda, but we getting that 3 points against Bermuda was very important for the continuation of our team in the tournament. And we got a draw, and it made things difficult for us, because even so, when Costa Rica lost against El Salvador too, that made Costa Rica coming out on that second game against us with a big fight too, because they back was also against the wall. But again, it's a good game. One of the areas I was always concerned with is in the final third, our goal scoring. You know, our main goal scorer, Nicholas Dillon, didn't play bad, but he just was out of Belgium, kind of way securing his contract there, and he came a little bit jaded, but he happened to work hard and work well. We saw young Caton Saint-Hilaire step up to the plate, as we would say, and doing well. But generally, I think that was one of the areas that I think I was a little concerned about, the final third, our goal scoring.
What do you think is next for this team now and this group of players?
Well, I'm hoping I'm looking at, I ain't getting to discussion yet with the TTFA, but continuation is key, because I think it's a really good squad that we built and put together. We have the under 23, under 21 football competitions to play, and I'm hoping that they could still keep that team into training, even self under the under 23 coach, and have that under 20 as a base, because I think it's important for us to prepare for 2022 World Cup qualifiers, and we need to start from now. So we already have a foundation, and all we need to do is to build on it as best as possible. But I'm expecting that good sense will prevail and those in authority will understand and know what it takes for us to go forward.
Coach, always a pleasure. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you so much.